realm of the senses, a man asleep imagines himself victorious until awake. For that is the jilted vision of the dreamer. Solemn until his mother's meal steams itself cold on the table exterior to his bedroom. Like insect and like vulture, he is enraptured and enslaved in the lower levels of thought, his mind turning primarily and primarily to a man's needs. In the midst of each horrific vision, each tenure of desire, glamorous flame extinguishes itself in the counting of last night's accomplishments of sorts. Coaxed with the body's release, the mint, mint, mint of our aura welfare revived. And yet, apathetically, we crave the return of slumber, the cocoon around us, the whir of past conversations and television programs bleating through the neighbor's walls. And we think of you, skewed and hungry, rolled and gullible. Over the sparkling, wondrous fragments of our deepest nightlife. We almost let ourselves slip again to sleep, knees knocking gently against the ceramic bowl, in rapture at the silhouettes outside. Thank you. Okay. Shopping. Shopping for breakfast. A simple, standard list. Starting at one end of town will make it seem quicker on the way back. I'd imagine minimal thoroughfare on the home stretch. But of course, this isn't my usual Wednesday. joke, a reference point to something said between Alice and myself half awake. To take such a wholesome adventure, with such goodwill, and wait on the platform, and tap our feet in anticipation. Not to sound overly poetic, but to believe that there was a simplicity, that if you have eaten, and slept, and laughed, and cried with such people, then we must endeavour to take spontaneous days out, and breathe the cleaner air of some barely foreign place. Is it not the goal to sit as a foursome with ease and peace of mind? She can look where she wants to look, and I will think nothing about her, although I know which two will share the towel. And I will calculate dates and similarities and the signals that she's given me as they talk, talk, talk. I will speak frankly to him as the impartial, and he will reply that there's nothing going on, nothing at all. He will look at me confused because he does not notice a thing. He does not need to notice, he says. He does not need to watch me from the corner of an eye or watch the whispered secrets whilst their hands are held tightly. He will ask me what I thought of Isabel the day we met, and I will not tell him the truth yet. I will say I never trusted her, but his point remains. And so I cling to the oldest photograph of Mia and I, our history, so many picturesque parks and gaudy winters, and realize I shall learn to see them like today.